Bande Guru Pada Dandam Bhakta Binda Samannitam Sri Chaitanya Prabhum Bande Nitha Nanda Sauditam Sri Nanda Nanda Nanga Bande Radhika Charanodayam Gopi Jano Samayuktam Binda Manohar Vancha Kalpataru Vesha Kipa Sindhu Bevacha Patitanang Pavune Bhavishna Bibhyo Namo Namaha Mukam Karoti Vacha Lang Pangung Lang Haitigiram Yat Kipatam Hung Bandi Paramananda Madhava Vrindavai Tulsidevai Piyavai Kesava Sacha Snabhakti Pade Devi Sattvavatvai Namo Namaha Narayana Namaskritta Narancaiva Narottamam Deving Saraswatiṃ Vyasam Tato Jayo Mudire Sankirtane Krishna Kathopadeshe Gauriya Patrasya Prakasanecha Sadanurakta Guru Bhakti Yukto Bhakti Pramodaksha Jagod Varanyam Deyam Sada Parivabhagnam Avishchaduham Tethas Padam Siva Virinchanutam Saranyam Vitatiham Ponotopal Bhavad Diputam Bande Mahapurusate Charanar Vindam Yat Pada Pallavanakachandamani Chatai Vispurijitagamapigopavadushu Adarshi Purnanuragara Sasagara Saramurti Saradhikamai Kadakipam Karoshi Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhunitananda Sri Advaita Gadadhara Sivasadi Gaura Bhaktavinda Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhunitananda Sri Advaita Gadadhara Sivasadi Gaura Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare. Ajanulambita bhujau kanuka budhatu Sankirtanai kapitaru kamalayatakshu Vishambaru dijavaru jugadharmapalu Bande yagat priyakaru karuna bhataru Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Namami Gange Tava Pad Pankajam Sura Surair Bandito Dibbarupam Bhuktin cha muktin cha dada sinitam Bhavanurupena sada naranam Ganga taranga ramaniya jata kalapam Gauri nirantara vibhushi tvam bhagam Narayano priyamanango madapaharam Varanasi purapati bhajavi shanatham Vagi shajusha vadane Lakshmir yasacha vakshasi yasyaasti hide sambhid tvam nishingamaham bhaji Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram Hare Ram 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 Hare Evam Manu Karma Basam Prajukte Avi Dayatmoni Upodhi Yomane Pritir Nayavad Maivasudeve Namu Chate Deho Yoge Natavat Evam Manaha Karamabasam Prajukte Avi Dayatmoni Upodhi Yomane Pritir Nayavad Maivasudeve Namu Chate Deho yoge natavad. Gauriya Goshipati, Sri Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur, Jagadguru Prabhupada told, after feeling the Sambandha Gyan, if you go on doing Harinam from your heart, then all different kind of dusanga, bad association, can automatically go away. Like camphor, you know. Gauriya Goshtipati, Sri Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada Jagadguru told, after feeling by the help of Guru Vaishnava, after feeling the sense of relationship, Sambandha Gyan, because Sambandha Janiya Bhajite Bhajite Abhimana Havedur, Sambandha Janiya Bhajite bhajite abhimano habe dur. If there is no sambandha gyan, then no question of going out of maya. First of all, from Guru Vaishnava we can get sambandha gyan. And after getting sambandha gyan, surely I can understand my duty. If you understand that I am your child, then automatically you can find your duty. Is my child level two, it is my responsibility, this seva. It's an automatic factor. So Sambandha Gyan is a must first, you'll have to get. After getting Sambandha Gyan, you can surely start a video. Before realizing Sambandha Gyan, you can start a video. It is absurd. Before developing any Sambandha Gyan inside your heart about Supreme Lord, Guru, Vaishnava, Bhagavan, you can start avidya. It is absurd. Then what to speak about prayajan, which is extreme, you know, point. So, Prabhupada speaking, after feeling this Sambandha Gyan, sense of relationship, if you go on doing Harinam, under the guidance of pure Guru Vaishnava, then all different kind of dusanga, bad association, can automatically go away. You need not play your head. Only you will have to be sincere in this matter. Those asasanga mean mayavadi, dry gani, mayavadi, gani, anyavilasi, all there. Actually, asasanga. Also, I was discussing about what Mahaprabhu wanted to say. Asasanga means Mahaprabhu wanted to say that those who are Mayavadi, etc., Krishna Abhakta, Krishna Abhakta, those who are not Bhakta of Krishna, but they are not Bhakta of Krishna. But they are not making any Vaishnava Aparad. They are not Bhakta. And after that, you know Krishna Bhakta, and after that, Sri Sangi, Yasi Sangi, I was calculating. So actually, Dusanga, all different kind of bad association, knowingly, unknowingly going to make disturbance in the way of your bhajan. Bhaktipat iho kantaka koti ruddho ha ha ka jami ki maham karomi chaitanya chanda yadi nadyam kripam karoshi. Very often Guru Padma used to say, this way of devotion, specially pure devotion, this way of pure devotion is really very, very excellent thing, very, very high. So excellent thing that in the way of this, you know, pure devotion, there is countless problem can come in your life. Countless problem. Bhaktipat iho kantaka kotir. Kantaka mean throne. Throne mean problem. Different kind of impediments come in the way of your bhajan and always can try to throw you away from bhajan. It is the duty of Maya. Maya first trying to throw you. Also those demigods in the heaven, they are also having some jealousy. When they watching, they has taken, they are, is doing nice bhajan. Especially those who are taking sannyasi externally, we can see, and those who are internally taking sannyas, is genuine sannyas. So those who are grihastha, like Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur, they are always sannyas. Their bhruto is always sannyas bhruto. They have taken bow of sannyas. Sannyas, we understand one red cloth and danda, this we think. But Bhagavan Sri Krishna explaining that those who are nitya sannyas, those who have no hatred, just are not going to hate anybody, nothing, no deshti, no kankheti, they have no demand, then their heart is so clean. They are not going to demand anything. Why? This kind of saturation point is only possible when you are going to get eternal service. Without devotional, activity service, this saturation point is not possible. This kind of saturation point, not. Geho so nitya sannyasi jona deshti na kankhati. Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking in Gita. Geho hi nitya sannyasi jona deshti na kankhati. Geho means it is, you should know it. Geho hi. Nitya sa nitya sannyasi jo na deshti na kankhati. Whereas having no desire, no expectation, nothing, no enmity, what to speak about, no, he has no jealousy, nothing. Heart is totally clear. He can see the whole world in relation to the Supreme Lord, even that not going to give pain to any insect. Jo na deshti na kankhati. Is not a no enemy, enmity with anybody. Very clean heart, he can see the whole world in relation to Supreme Lord and always in love, doing loving service. So he is sannyasi. Sannyas, this broto, those who are Mayavadi, they think if we leave our all activities, everything, then we are sannyas. But I already yesterday proved, nobody can leave activities. You will have to prakite kriyamanani guna karmair avasa. Prakite kriyamanani. Prakriti going to engage you in different kind of activities. You say, I am living karma. But the sannyas, this word, is applicable when Sri Krishna Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, when taking sannyas, giving the exact explanation of sannyas. People think Mayavadis, they are sannyasis, but actually not sannyasis. They are not sannyasis. Prabhu kahe sannyas vrata karilo grahan, mukunda sevan vrata karilo grahan, mukunda sevai hai sangsataran. Prabhu kahe, Mahaprabhu, after taking sannyas, singing the glory of Supreme Lord, he himself Supreme Lord, but singing the glory, you have to cut material bondage. How you can understand Rai Ramananda Sangbad, which is the topmost thing. Impossible. So Bhagavan Sri Krishna, after taking sannyas, speaking, प्रभु कहे मुकुंद सेवन व्रत कई लोग हन मुकुंद सेवाय है संसार तारण इफ यू लाइक टू क्रॉस ओवर दिस मेटेरियल वर्ल्ड इफ यू लाइक टू अरेंज सम गुड फॉर दिस इनहेबिटेंट ऑफ दिस सोसाइटी दोज हु आर स्टेइंग इन दिस मेटेरियल वर्ल्ड ओनली सन्यासी कैन डू सन्यासी इज ही हु इज हैविंग ऑलवेज मर्सीफुल दर्शन merciful vision whenever he is look at anybody even beast on birds everything has some compassion on them even in bhagavatam it is written 11th canto bhagavan sri krishna speaking those who are really taking sannyas I am not speaking about false sannyas But actually in Bhagavatam it is written, those who are taking actual sannyas, they are feeling the whole world is their children. Even beasts and birds, everything, they are their children. Father, compassionate heart, very, very soft heart actually. They are always busy to render some good, you know, service on behalf of Supreme Lord. They like to do something. I mean, Nam Sankirtan, everything. To help them to increase their consciousness. This is their duty, sannyas. That's why Mahaprabhu speaking, Prabhu kahe sannyas vrata koi log hon, mukunda sevai hoy sangsar taran. This by the service of Supreme Lord, we can cross this material very easily. Sannyas mantra, when we are getting from Guru Pad Padma, there is one mantra, I should not speak it clearly, But this mantra is also in Bhagavatam. But actually, last of chanting sannyas mantra, we have to chant this mantra also. There it is also written very clearly that all the time you have to serve Supreme Lord and all jivatma. They are suffering, so you will have to calculate how to. Arrange their goods so that they can get maximum benefit, maximum most benefit. I mean, they can increase their consciousness, and this is our duty. If we can increase their, help them to increase their consciousness, chetanar vikas, then that they can discover what is their duty. That is why until and unless we are not going to grow our loveful relation with Supreme Lord. Then up to then there is no stoppage of our death and birth cycle. So anyhow, whole bhajan procedure totally yogi gyani whatever they are doing ultimately they will have to enjoy some favor of Bhakti Devi. Without the favor of Bhakti Devi, slight bhakti must be there. Without that, even in their respective line, they are not going to come out successful. So, bhakti must be there. Bhakti, mixing of bhakti must be there. Without that, they never, yogi, jnani, they can never come out successful. So, it's a must. Bhakti is totally satantra. So until and unless we are going to grow our nice, loveful relationship with the Supreme Lord by the help of Guru Vaishnava, till then we'll have to take birth. That's, meaning death and birth cycle can go on. Evam manu karma basam prayukte avidyatmoni upadhiyamane प्रीतिर्न यावदमैवासुदेवे नामोच्यते देहो योगेन तावत् आवर कॉन्शियसनेस इज जस्ट कवर्ड अप कॉन्शियसनेस ऑलरेडी देयर बिकॉज जीवात्मा जीव आत्मा इज इक्वली ज्ञानमय वस्तु द चित पार्टिकल देयर इनसाइड माय बॉडी For which I am doing everything, I am feeling everything, I am enjoying everything what I am doing. Because the Jivatma, the chit particle is there, is Anandamaya. So always, you know, is Gyanamaya and Nitya Sthiti. Nitya Anandamaya, Nitya Gyanamaya and Nitya Sthiti, eternally present. Three qualities there. I mean, why when we are saying Bhagavan is Satchit Anandamaya, Sat means Nitya. Sat mean, if you search your dictionary, you can find Sat mean honest. But Sat mean honest. But Sat mean actually Sanskrit deep meaning if you understand, then you can find Sat mean eternal Sat. Sat mean eternally present. Eternally present. Actually existence never, you know, existence never, and never exist, meaning exist, eternal existence there. That's why Sat. Sat means eternally present. And what is not eternally present, you are busy with all those things, this is called Asat. Sat and Asat, the demarcation is that. If you understand that these things, what I am and thinking, it's not eternal, you know, by the period of time, Kaler Prabhave, by the influence of time, is going to be destroyed. Whatever excellent thing it can be, it is destructible. It is called anitta. It is called anitta mean asat. And sat mean eternal presence. So jivatma sat. So eternally present. Sat chit. Chit. Sat chit. Chit mane actually chinmoy. Not material, Satchit, Anandamaya. Satchit Anandamaya, like Bhagavan. So, our mind and everything, body, all, even our subconscious, everything covered up by Maya, enveloped by the power of Maya, enveloped by. That's why, actually, Nitya Gyan is there inside. Atma is Gyanamaya Vastu. But we cannot realize. We are crying, we are feeling pain, we are suffering so much. That's why any line you follow, first of all, actually, we'll have to cut bondage. Without cutting bondage, without cutting bondage, you cannot become successful. Not possible. Mano eva manasvanam karana bandhana mukshayo. Mano eva manusvanam karana bandhana mukshayo. Bandhan moksho. Bandhan mean bondage, moksho mean mukti. This mukti I already told many times before, long before. Preliminary definition of mukti is to get rid of maya. Preliminary definition of mukti is to get rid of the and the influence of the three modes of nature. But this is not final. This is basic thing. This is basic thing actually. To mukti. After that, you know, you can think what to do. After getting out of this problem of maya, then you will have to settle down what to do. If you are not going to do bhajan, again if you are thinking about, you know, different kind of things which is very dirty thing, like sajujum, different kind of things you are thinking, like mayavadi, then actually your bhajan, you cannot do bhajan. So after mukti, what is the question is, Popa speaking, after getting mukti, what is your duty? You will have to discover. So all our consciousness, everything, mind, everything covered up by the influence of maya. That is why we cannot. So evam manu karma basam prayukte. Our mana, mind, material mind is full of matter. I told you yesterday, even externally you find there is My sense organ is under control, everything, you know, you can speak this way. But actually, I already told, karmendriyani sanyammu yu aste manasa smaran indiya arthanam vimaratva vittacharaha sauchyate. Karmendriyani sanyammu yu aste manasa smaran. Externally, he is having control over karmendriya. But he is a cheater because mentally he is thinking everything. So mind is the weakest, you know, very dangerous thing. Karmendriyani sanyammu ya aste manasasmaran indiya arthanu vimuratma mithacharaha sauchyati. The mithachar is mentally he is always getting, you know, association, dirty association, material association. So mind can never go back end. It is not possible. Something must be there. Mind can never go back end. It is not possible that you can, even yogi, yeah, they cannot totally, they are going to avaruddha mana, they are going to control, fully check off. But still something must be there. Mind can never be back end. You cannot make back end, total back end. But it is very nice procedure if you can give a sweet turn. It's good, more practical. If you go on fighting with your mind, then it can make you double problem, triple problem. So don't try to fight with your maya. You can never come out successfully, forcefully. Forcefully, if you like to apply control of your maya, forceful, no, I cannot do it. You can say double. You would be in trouble, double. So if you try to apply force, you cannot come out, sir. But then what is the procedure? If you can see excellent thing, if you can help your mind to get engaged in a very nice thing, is so excellent, then automatically you can find the mind can get engaged. So you will have to take this procedure, which is you have to give a sweet turn. So actually, point is that param dishta nivartante. Param dishta mane actually, if you find some nice thing, so automatically your mind you are going to feel attraction for that. In that case you can, you know, check your mind. You can divert your mind. In that case you can come out successful. So, what I am speaking, actually, if you fight with your mind, you can never come out successful. First of all, by the help of Guru Vaishnava, you can go on following your procedure and let the mind go, and you try to check again and again, do your own thing. And when your mind can get attraction for some nice thing, then automatically mind can check. Param dishta nivartante. When you can find nice thing, what is that nice thing? Yesterday I was thinking, nothing is nice, only Bhagavan and his related things. If you can feel attraction, then you can get rid of all problem. Otherwise there is no. Sarva eva mano nigraha lakshananta. Any procedure you follow, gyan yog, dhyan yog, anything, karma yog, anything, you know, you will have to get control over your mind. Get control over your mind first. Sarva eva mano nigraha lakshananta. First of all, you will have to get control of your mind. Avashivuta man, uncontrolled mind, cannot help you anyway. cannot help you to do bhajan. So how to speak about Raganuga Bhajan Rupan? You are thinking so many things. Your mind running towards money, this, that, position, woman, all attachment there, pratishtha. You can become fed up. You can become fed up. That's why I started with this sloka. Evam mano karma basam prajukte avidyatmo ni upadhiyamane prithirnayavadamivasudeve namuchate deho yoge natavat. You cannot get out of any problem, out of problem. No. If you are going to develop loveful relation to the Supreme Lord, then you can. Otherwise, your mind, your body, everything, man, karmadhin. Karmadhin are controlled by karma. You cannot avoid karma. You cannot avoid karma. But be careful, you can point out that answer already given by Krishna. Maharaj, we cannot get control, you know, okay. But those Janakadi, Rishi, why they are doing karma? It is Krishna Bhagavan speaking. Now, actually, karma naivahi saṃsiddhim asthita janakādayoho loko-saṅgro-mevāpi saṅpasam kartu marasi. Janakādi, there are their topmost, you know, jnani, they know everything, you know. Even Sukhdeva Goswami going to get kripa from Janakadi Rishi. So big, big Mani Rishi, they are going to get some advice from Janakaraj. But externally you can find he is busy with, you know, all, you know, activities there as Raja, King. But actually he is doing because if he is not going to do, he is important personality in the society, then everybody can, everybody can follow that procedure. So loko sangrahenapi, to engage them in service, there is going giving order, you know, to make a nice setup of the society. Because anyway, if there is no varnasam dharma, there is no conception of any dharma outside world, they know nothing. Within this area, within this field of Veda, Vedic culture, they have little, but not clear. The conception of Dharma is not at all clear. Though they are following some other Dharma, you know, apparent Dharma, but the conception of Dharma, even not clear with those people, those who are within the area of Vedic, you know, field, still they don't understand. Confusion. I told yesterday. So actually, it is written, Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking to Arjuna, Arjuna, I have nothing to do. I am a saturated personality. I need not do anything. I need not do anything. But still I am doing, you know, why? Because if I am not doing, then there is a big problem, because everybody can run wrong way. So this sloka is very important. You know everybody, I think, most of you, those who are in Vaishnava, you know, darshan, Vaishnava, you know, line. Yad yad acharati sestaha stattat devetaro janaha sayat pramanam kurute lokahastadanu vartate. Very important personality going to do, or other people, they are also going to follow. That is why it was the practice of Srila Prabhupada, Radha Dasya, to invite important personalities, big, big people from the society, so that common people can get some inspiration, they can run to come, they can come, they can run and come and see what is happening, they can get some benefit. That is why it was one kind of Radha Dasya on the part of Prabhupada, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati. So, yad yad acharati sreshtah tat tat evetaro janah Sajat pramanam kurute lokahastad anuvartate. So common people usually going to follow those who are remarkable personalities. They are going to. Now Bhagavan speaking, Partho, Krishna, look. I have no duty, but still I am doing. You know why? To engage them, to show them the way. Because they are not qualified to live karma. It is also my advice all the time speaking. Unnecessarily, those who are in kama, krodha, or everything. If I am going to advise, you can come, leave everything. His material attachment there, family life attachment fully there. Unnecessarily, if I advise him, you leave everything and come. Or he was doing business, attachment, everything, children, all he leave and come. Now after that, what happened? Because he was doing his duty. He was not up to that mark. His you know, right was up to that much. But that Acharya going and catching him. After that, what happened? His family life finished, wife gone, finished, children or everything finished, business finished. His material mind is not under control because he is not hearing Harikatha from that Acharya, or at all hearing it is not at all Harikatha. Because if Harikatha, the only medicine is Harikatha. I am going to discuss this point to understand in what condition I am now at present to understand. Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking, Name parthasti kartabhyam trishu lokesh kinchana. In this world, in three worlds, there is no duty. I have no duty. But still I am doing. Because jodihi aham na varteyam, if I am not going to engage myself in my duty, and people cannot see, people can see I am not doing my duty, they can also run opposite way. That's why jodihi aham na varteyam yatu karmani atandritaha Mamo Bhartan Vartante Manushaha Partho Sarvasa. Because I am the super personality, Supreme Godhead. And if I am going to show that I have no duty, so I can, if I stop anything, then everybody can do fancifully, go wrong way. And this way Varnasam Dharma cannot stand, can collapse, break down. Now somebody can ask Maharaj, outside world, there is no Varnasam Dharma, no Vedic culture, nothing, what they are doing. To be frank, they are apparently following some Dharma, Christian Dharma or Isai. I am not criticizing, I am speaking scientifically. They are following something, Isai Dharma, Buddhist Dharma, anything. But through this dharma, what they are following at present is apparent dharma. They cannot get realization power. Only, you know, it is one kind of, they are doing, so I must do. This way they are doing. And this way, so somebody can ask me, then how they are so financially, technically, so advanced, Maharaj? Already Bhaktivinoda Thakur told, and I am also speaking the same thing. The only thing for why they're climbing the hill of prosperity, material prosperity. What can be the reason, you know? What can be the reason? The only reason, they are taking very vital point from our this Varnasam Dharma. But what thing, Maharaj, we never heard? Yes, we never heard. I am speaking. You can remember, I told you, according to right, sasa adhikare yanishtaha sa gunaha parikirtita, viparya sudosaha. So according to their own right, they are engaged, we should get engaged in seva. Not that I can break everything. So what is the right? According to my previous sanskar, what kind of tendency, what kind of, you know, tendency, you know, sin in my life, that is very important. And also same thing is speaking, you know, there, spoken in Bhagavatam and all other, Mahabharata, I already told. That Varnasam Dharma category, people think that Brahman, he is the son of Brahman, so he must be Brahman. Not that. Not that. I already explained Varnasam Dharma when I discussed, long discussion. They already discussed. This is not the procedure through which they can. It depends according to Janma. Sometimes we are always busy to detect according to that. But according to Shastra, I already shown that taken birth in Brahman family, but is not his character and behavior is not at all Brahman. It's totally opposite. So Rishi Muni, this is their arrangement according to his, you know, I already told Rishabdev is Kshatriya. Rishabdev, he is Bhagavan, but still now king, Kshatriya. So now my question is that how it was possible for those, you know, 80 sons, 80 of his sons, 100 sons, after that, they become Karmakandi Brahman. How it is possible? There is the main question. So also, Parashuramji Maharaj, he is taking birth, but acting like Kshatriya. There is so many documents I can show you. So, Vasishtha Muni going to take birth, second time take birth from Urvashi, this, that, so many, you know. Agastya Muni from a pitcher, you can laugh because your conception cannot support. Anything I'm going to speak, you are going to search your experience bank. If you don't find, oh, it cannot be so. You can speak. It cannot be so. You can speak. Rishasinga Muni, he is Brahman. But he took birth from a deer. Rishasinga Muni. Follow. This way, Dronacharya from Drona, the pot where all, you know, arrow we are keeping. Dronacharya. So it is one kind of absurd conception to you. But you have seen when raw rice, I mean atapchal, raw rice, you know, not boiled. That when raw rice, if you put in one place for long time, it is just spoiled, and after that you can discover there's Scorpio. Scorpio, you can find there. Raw rice, when get, you know, totally spoiled, and by water and air, everything, sunlight, they get spoiled totally from there, and we can find insect, like insect. After that, when that insect is going to grow, we find is you know, one, many different type of insects can go, but I am giving now example of Scorpio. The Scorpio can take birth from father and mother. Scorpio can take birth from father and mother. Also, if you keep raw rice for a long time, also it is possible. From there you can find the Scorpio develop. So this kind of different kind of, also from sweat, from sweats, it can grow some different kind of insects. From sweat, sweat means gum, from our body, and so there, from sweat, there are also different kind of insect developing. So, the procedure of Bhagavan, Supreme Lord, is so vast. If we play our head, we can go mad. See, it is good if we take the help of Bhakti Yoga. So, that is why I am explaining so much thing. So, you see, Bhagavan speaking, if I am not going to do my duty, because Bhagavan Sri Krishna also doing his duty in the form of Kshatriya coming here. Bhagavan speaking, if I am not going to do my duty, then whole Varnasam system can break down. Main Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, the main benefit of this Varnasam Ashram, Varnasam Dharma, is to regulate this society scientific way. If this Varnasam Dharma break down, then all mismanagement will be there. All dirty, at present what you see. All dirty thing happens. So long as the society had respect for this Varnasam Dharma, up to that point it was very okay. Satya Yuga, after that, Varnasam Dharma eternally present, but still we see Bhagavan Sri Krishna giving, but eternally present it is. Previously Rishi Muni speaking, but after that Bhagavan in Gita writing this way. So all, you know, the system can break down. So now I am going to give answer to your question. When you are putting question in front of me, how it is possible that Maharaj, foreign countries, there those who are Vaishnav, now I am not speaking about them, those are out of this, the field of Vedic culture. They also, they are climbing the topmost hill of prosperity, material prosperity. How? Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, the only reason for why they are climbing the hill of topmost hill of prosperity, material prosperity. What is the reason? Well, Maharaj, unknowingly, they are following one very nice policy. What is that policy? In their society, from childhood, they are watching. Boy, in kindergarten, in, you know, in, they are watching. What is the feeling of this boy? If they find this boy is philosopher, like philosophy they like, they are giving them chance to follow that procedure. When they find there is a very nice ingenuity, is always busy with, you know, they like to do this, do that, they are going to help that way. When sports is very good, which sports, which way, they are going to help. According to this principle, which is the basic principle, they don't know, knowingly or unknowingly, I don't know. They are following this procedure, that is why we can see prosperity in their life. Also, another point, though we deserve that we are honest, but we are actually not honest. Honesty is not there. Basically, they are going to follow some rules and regulations set by government. But here are all economy, everything controlled by some mafia. Whole economy dancing according to the indication of mafia. So how we can get prosperity? Their economy, everything, they're very nice because Chanakya Pandit, he wrote so many things. Even big, you know, economists, still today they are thinking what kind of thesis given by him. Not a matter of joke, you know. So, their economy is controlled by demand and supply, which is the basic thing of economics. Which is the basic thing, basic structure of economics. What is that? Supply, demand and supply. So, according to demand, supply can be met. If there is no demand, supply can go down. So, they are following this procedure. That is why their economy is flowing. That is why their economy is flowing freely. That is why they are getting success in any field. Because in sports, in scientific research, I already give one example you can remember. Har Gobind Khurana, he was an Indian scientist. He was doing research on genetic factor. By he applied to Indian government, I need this kind of help for my research. Almost I am successful, I can prove. By government speaking, we have no money to help you. That government, at present government, I am not speaking about him, this government. This government say, no, we have no money, we cannot help. That they apply to in American government. That American government immediately speak, when you are coming, now? Immediately special visa, officer, passport, he was an important scientist. And he gone there. He was bound to go there. And after that, within short period, he was successful to prove the thesis. And he got Nobel Prize. So now American people can speak that we are getting Nobel Prize. But actually, who is getting Nobel Prize? One scientist who is originally from India. And there, any scientist, any doctor, there should not be any political barrier. They are free. We cannot confine them within one, you know, area. They are free anyway. So this way, actually, that is why they are getting this kind of achievement, because they are following their nature. What is the nature of the boy? According to that, they are helping. Here, only educational qualification, if you are going to get service, they are going to see what is your educational qualification. Competition is there. By educational qualification, they can see. But in foreign country, if somebody going to appear in the exam or in competition for the service, if graduation done by one man, his aptitude is so high, his knowledge is so high, but education is not master degree. But here they can throw you out, but they are not. They can see this graduate who is having very nice aptitude, very nice, you know, idea, and this post-graduation, you know, who among them, you know, useful for us. According to that, they can select. That is why they are going to, what I mean to say, they are going to engage right man in right place. Try to understand, this is the formula. They are going to engage right man in right place. They are going to engage right man in right place. And that is the basic thing. That is the basic thing of our, that is the basic thing of our Varnasam Dharma, you know. That is the basic thing, no? So that is why they are successful and we are not successful, because we are playing politics in devotional line, in educational fields, in sports fields. Everywhere we are busy with politics. You know. That is why we are not successful. There you can find in America two parties, Democratic and Republic. Here countless parties. You also can make a new party to make confusion. So people, whether they are people, they are in confusion. So according to Varnasam Dharma, I discussed long ago that you cannot specify a man according to his birth. No, not possible. That is why I told Bhagavat Praman in Bhagavatam, Yasho yat lakshanam praktam pungso varnavi vyanjakam tadannatrapi drisheto tatte naiva vinirdishet. Yasho yat lakshanam praktam. According to Varna Dharma, somebody taking birth, if suppose somebody taking birth in Brahman race, but his character and behavior is not going to prove there is at all Brahman, so accordingly we'll have to arrange. Maybe he is Kshatriya. So you'll have to indicate. That is why just Bhagavad, the topmost Praman, Jasho yad lakshanam praktam pungso varnavi vyanjakam tadannatrapi disheta tatte naiva vinirdishet. You will have to consult tatta, and accordingly we'll have to. That's why Jabal Sattakam, I already told, there is no surety of his birth. Even Jabal Sattakam cannot speak who is his father. Asking mother, but mother can also cannot give any answer. But still Gautami Muni is speaking, Brahmane Arjavu Shakshat Shudre Anarjava Lakshanam. Brahman is always truthful, speaking always, and his etiquette, behavior, acharan is so pure. So, according to this formula, Gautami Muni was 100% sure, my son, my boy, you come. I am sure that you are Brahman. But because without Brahman, this kind of naked truth, you cannot speak. So you are speaking in front of public, so you are Brahman. You come. The symptom speaking that you are Brahman. Outside people, they are showing some success in material field, but be sure, they are not success in spiritual field. At present, those who are Vaishnava, I am not speaking about them. Spiritual progress, overall progress, if you discuss, then India is the topmost place. Where? Karma khetra. Dharma khetra, karma, karma khetra, you know, Kuru khetra, in the Gita, first, you know, discussing actually. So, in India, here, it's possible that you can follow Vedic rules and regulation, everything. If you follow, if you are staying outside, if you try to follow, you can try. Dharma khetra kuru khetra samaveda yudhisthira. There is the first sloka of Gita. And actually, what I mean to say, all karma system, because nobody can avoid karma, I already proved yesterday. I was bound to prove. Nobody can avoid karma. Because according to their sanskar, prakriti kriyamanani gunoi karmani sarvasaha ahankara vimuratta karta aham iti mannate. Actually, prakriti going to engage you. But you think you are doing, that is your fault. That is why this ahankar false ego going to put me in trouble. Doership. That is why in Gita Bhagavan speaking, those who are blind people, those who have no idea about what is karma, what is gyan, what is bhakti, what is no tattva-gyan, nothing, totally blind, crude personality. He was totally absorbing, you know, he was in, you know, absorbing enjoyment, material enjoyment. Now, immediately if you catch him and say, you come, I can make you gopi, you can start, you know, manjari bhajan. How possible, Maharaj? He cannot even realize his own, you know, self. It's not possible. That is why Bhagavan, those who are going to avoid Gita, I am 100% sure, they are going to die. They cannot spiritually, they cannot come out, they don't understand the basic thing. Bhagavan giving instruction to Arjun, those who are totally in absorbing condition, don't know nothing except this body, material body, mind, building, you know, property, everything, know nothing. For them, it is dangerous. Don't try to stop their, you know, stop their, you know, mood. Because you cannot come out successful. It is, on the contrary, it will be a big danger for them. Because they are not, gradually you will have to try in a moderate way, so that they can themselves realize. Like the example of that Tirandi Sannyasi from Bhagavatam, it's very appropriate example. Guru Pad Padma used to speak, Srila Bhakti Pompuriyusa Paramahansa used to speak sometime. That, see my boy, he was engaged in business, this is too much attachment for material things. He don't like to understand anything, even the demand of children and wife is going to ignore. No? So naturally they were very angry with him. But someday he lost everything. It is the arrangement of, you know, Supreme Lord, I think. He is speaking that way. It is the arrangement of Supreme Lord. He lost everything, all money gone, property gone, those were son and daughters and wife, they throw him outside because all property gone. King coming to collect, tax everything forcefully. And dacoits come and, you know, take everything. He was penniless. He was thrown out of his house, home. After that, somehow by the mercy of Chaitya Guru, inside Supreme Lord, in the form of Chaitya Guru staying there, he is developing detachment. As he is developing detachment, he is watching that this condition reached now, that the condition reached now, it must be the mercy of Supreme Lord. Otherwise, so for so long time and never feeling that way, that all unstable. I never thought I never thought that all unstable, but now I feel all unstable, nothing, permanent. So I must try to satisfy Supreme Lord. I must take sannyas to serve Supreme Lord totally. That's why he took sannyas, Tirunda sannyas. And after that, so much torture. There was so much, you know, torture. Public, my small boys and public, they are doing so much torture against him. But still he was not feeling any problem. Because naturally it came inside his heart. Automatically. That's why Dhir sannyas and Vidyat sannyas, Dhir sannyas, you know, Narottama sannyas, Dhir sannyas, Narottama sannyas. Vidya sannyas, so many, same thing actually. It's very important. Narottama sannyas and Dhir sannyas. Narottama sannyas, Dhir sannyas. So actually, Bhagavan giving instruction to Arjuna, Arjuna, don't try to disturb them, those who are materially absorbed. Gradual procedure, very soft procedures they wanted, because otherwise they can, in the between, you know, midway, they can break down. They cannot do, they cannot success, they cannot come out successful, they cannot, because you know already they are going to leave their present condition and present right, they are going to throw. That's why they cannot, according to their right there. So Krishna Goma, Bhagavan Sri Krishna giving instruction, the prakriter guna sangmura sajjante guna karmasu. Prakriter guna sangmura. Those who are idiot people, foolish. They are controlled by the three modes of nature. Foolish, darkness, ignorant, you know. Sajjante guna karmasu. They are busy with the three modes of nature. Satatama, sato, rajo, tamagun. Sato, rajo, tamagun, they are busy. They are always busy. So in that case, actually, sato, rajo, tamagun, they are busy. Tano, you should not disturb them. That's why Krishna Bhagavan speaking, prakriter guna sangmuraha. Sajjante gunakarmasu tano akrishna vidho mandano krishna vid na vichalayat. Don't try to disturb them. Don't try to disturb them. If you break their, you know, conception, then they cannot reach, you know, this, either this way or that way. Anyway, either way they can, problem there's. Both way, problem, dilemma. So prakriter guna sangmuraha sajjanti guna karmasu tano akrishno vido mandano krishno vid na vicharet. Those who have no knowledge, they are in darkness. Immediately if you break their conception, they cannot reach any good, nothing. So better you wait. And gradually, that's why Janakadi Rishi is very clever. Janakadi Rishi always used to engage them. Bhagavan Sri Krishna also wanted to engage them in their own right, you know, and duty. So they can sadharma nidhanam seho paradharma bhayabhav. Sadharma nidhanam seho paradharma bhayabhav. So paradharma, you are actually khatriya. Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking to Arjuna, Arjuna, you are khatriya. So naturally, your khatriya sabha, nature. You will like to ignore your duty, you like to do, you know, lead your life like Brahman Vaishnava and be begging. No, not good. It's not good. So, sadharma nidhanam sreyo paradharma bhayabha. Try to understand, I am discussing about the minimum conception of dharma, which can come within this area of Vedic culture, not outside. Because outside people, they are so-called Dharma, Christian, they are following. But Bhaktivinoda Thakur in Jayavadana writing, according to their status, present condition, they are following. But they, someday, if their luck is good, they can realize, they can change their track. But let them do it. See, it's quite natural they can fall. So, I am discussing within this area, those who are within this area of Vedic field. So, Prakritir Guna Sangmudha Sajjanti Guna Karmasu. They are engaged in guna karma, always. Guna karma, they are doing. According to the influence of three modes of sattva, raja, tamagun, they are doing. Bhagavan Sri Krishna is bringing, don't disturb them right now. Tano, akrishna, vido, mandano, those who are dull ben. Their ben is dull. They are ignorant. Those who are gani, krishna, vid, navichalet. They should not disturb them right now. Because to get bhakti, to understand that Vasudeva is everywhere, not a matter of joke. Even if you can understand that everywhere, if you can feel that Supreme Lord is there. That's why Bhagavan speaking, Bahunam janma jamante, Bahunam janma namante, Jnana vanam mam prapaddati, Vasudeva sarvamiti, sa mahatva sudurrabha. This kind of Mahatma, Mahatma and Sadhu, is almost rare. Who can realize that everywhere he can feel the Vasudev? Everywhere Vasudev, Bhagavan. So it's rare. But we are jumping like monkey to catch a moon. A monkey can jump. How can catch moon? Impossible. Where is moon and where is monkey? But we are jumping like monkey. It's a painful condition. So, Bhagavan Sri Krishna is speaking, you should not disturb it right now, in gradual procedure of his, you know, nature. Nature can change. Because Sangha, by actual association, you can change your nature. Not that overnight you can change your nature. Not that overnight you can change your... If you love Guru Vaishnava, if you are hearing Harikatha, you are doing appropriate association, the impact of association, the result of association is that, surely you are going to change your mood. Not that you are doing association, same mood there, not possible, not possible. Iha yogati sajjana sangati rega. Iha jagati sajjana sangati reka bhavati bhavati bhavarnava tarane nauka. To cross over this material world, the only way is there, you will have to take good association, satsanga. What Mahaprabhu going to, and they're going there, it is one kind of satsanga. And also there is a deep philosophy, deep, you know, planning. The Bhagavan wanted to unveil the mystery of total bhajan procedure. What is karma, what is gyan? Gan Mr. Karma, all everything in details. Through this procedure, those who are not going through Sanatana Sikha, those who are not going through Rupa Sikha, those who are not going through Rai Ramananda Sangbad, those who are not going through Chaitanya Bhagavad, they should leave bhajan. Because never they can do. Gita, they don't understand. So, at least those who are Gauri devotees, they should realize this thing, minimum. Otherwise, they have no entry. So, even basic conception of Gita should be there, so that misunderstanding cannot take place. So, that is why it is written that we should not disturb, but they can follow. That, you know, those who are big personality, Janak Maharaj doing, to engage them. Those who are ignorant, they to engage them in their own their respective seva, they engage in. Actually, Vaishnava is not a matter of joke. After that, I can come to the point yesterday, already touched, that anyway, whenever you have taken birth, you have some duty, you are indebted. You know, I already told 2 days ago, Rishi Din, Devrin, Pitrin, Bhutarin, all I all discussed before. And Vaishnava is not a matter of joke. You have to understand very. So who is Vaishnava? Baba speaking, if we are going to search the whole world, I am not speaking, if you challenge, I can show the writings of Prabhupada. Prabhupada means Bhakti Siddhanta, the Prabhupada, at present confusion. So I can show you the where Prabhupada, when told, I can show you. So Prabhupada speaking, if we search out the whole world, if we make a comb operation, if we are going to make a conduct a comb operation all over the world, search the whole world very carefully. Prabhupada speaking, the number of Vaishnavas is so rare, so rare. Prabhupada speaking, if you search the whole world, you can see pure Vaishnava, who is exact Vaishnava, approved by Supreme Lord. Not a matter of joke. So, actually, you must understand this in a sloka already I discussed before. Brahmananam sahasrebyo satrayaji vishishyati satrayaji sahasrebyo sarva vedanta paragaha sarva vedanta vitkatya vishnu bhakto vishishyati vaishnavanam sahasrebyo ekantiko vishishyati vaishnavanam sahasrebyo. Those who are going to worship Vishnu, some through Varnasam Dharma, these, that, they are worshipping somehow. Externally, they are following Varnasam Dharma, these, that, they are following. But anyway, their ultimate goal is to satisfy Vishnu. Vaishnavanam Sahasrabho, this is Vaishnavanam Sahasrabho, countless Vaishnava, out of countless Vaishnava, a pure Vaishnava Paramahansa is really rare. Even if you cannot imagine what a rare thing. So the advice we should follow, that is Sriyano Sadharma Vigunaha Paradharmat Sanushtitat Sadharma Nidanam Sriyaha Paradharma Bhayabha. But you can remember when first question was that Mahaprabhu, I can discuss. Sadharma, what do you mean by Sadharma? Now coming this question, what is Sadharma? Sadharma means if you are in the area of Vedic field, then Sadharma means the guna evang karma vibhag Bhagavan Sri Krishna making according to your guna evang karma, guna and karma. So you are going to follow a particular procedure to get success. That is why Bhagavan Sri Krishna indicating Sriyano Sadharma. Suppose one Khachiyo immediately going to throw everything and he like to become Brahman. It's not possible. Whereas the nature can speak, what is your condition, present condition? 80 sons of Rishabh Dev, they become Brahman. I already told how it was possible. So, Sriyana Sadharma Vigunaha Paradharmat Sanastita. Though at present he thinks that this the Vigunaha, Sadharma, my Dharma is not good. I should throw it and take another Dharma which is better than this. No. So Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking, Sriyano Sadharma Vigunaha, though it is, some procedure, some principles are there which I cannot admit. Still, Sriyana Sadharma Vigunaha Paradharma Vigunaha. I know it is not up to the mark. It is not good, so nice. But still, Paradharma Bhayava. Paradharma is dangerous. And Sadharma Nidhanam Sriya Paradharma Bhayava. Bhagavan says to me, if you are going to die by the procedure of following your Sadharma, someday you can get success, which is permanent. But if you are going to jump, then you can break your leg and head. You cannot come out successful. Sadharma Nidhanam Sriya. You will have to discharge your duty as Khatriya, because Khatriya, nature is fighting. Khatriya is duty, I already told many times. What all other duties of Khatriya, I already told many times. So those who are Kshatriya, they must do their own duty, who is sannyasi, who is, you know, Vaishya, Shudra, Ashram among Varna. Varna among Ashram, they must follow their Ashram and Varna. According to their Ashram and Varna, according to ashram and dharma, according to their quality grade, according to their, you know, right, they must do. Those who are Kshatriya, they must do their duty. I already told you, Kshatriya, if he is going to follow opposite mark, opposite way, like Brahman, the quality of Brahman already, you know, I already discussed many times before. Samo damaha stapo saucham khyantir arjava mevacha jnanam vijnanam astikyam brahma karma sabhavajam. You know. And Kshatriya dharma saurjam teja dhitir dakshyam juddhe chapi apalayanam danam isvara bhavancha khatra karma sabhavajam. And Vaishyas and Shudra, wow, na krishi goraksho banijam vaishya karma sabhavajam paricharyatmakam karma shudra swapi sabhavajam is already given in Gita. So according to that, you will have to, you know, to engage yourself in service. Otherwise, you can never come out successful. That is the big problem. So now actually, there is a big danger actually, because if there is desire, different kind of desire, there is no indication of any devotional, you know, mood. In that case, if you are going to follow this procedure, that procedure, there is big problem. And if you are under the by the mercy of Guru Vaishnava, if you are getting right track, right time, appropriate, then no problem. Then you can pay all the debts. You can pay. Because I told yesterday, Devarsi Bhutatmu Ninam Pitrinam No Kinkara Nayam Rinicha Rajana Sarvatmana Yah Saranam Saranyam Gato Mukundam Parihitta Kartam. If they are going to, you know, fall, you know, going to get full kippa, you know, and they are going to serve the lotus feet of Mukunda, Paratpara Krishna, totally inclined, Saranagata. In that case, he need not play his head. Devarshi, that I told Nina yesterday, that Devarin, Pitrin, Bhutrin, or nothing can, you know, put you in problem. Devarsi bhutatma ninam pitrinam na kinkaro nayam rini cha rajan. Hey Rajan, if they are going to follow the pure devotional tract, Shuddha Bhakti, they are going to serve the lotus feet of Supreme Lord, in that case they need not play head over their duty, anything. They can leave everything, no problem. Devarshi bhutatmaninam pitrinam na kinkara nayam rini. He is not, you know, he need not pay anything to anybody. He is not, you know, need not pay his debt to anybody. He is free because he is doing Krishna bhajan, Bhagavan Vishnu bhajan. That's why ultimately if we are going to leave varnasrama dharma, that's not a problem. But on right time, right thing you will have to do. Yatha tarar mool nisecha nena tippanti tatskanda hujopasaka pranupahara suyathendriyanam tathaiva arharanam sat ochitejya. Ochitejya, when you are going to serve ochita, worship ochita, Bhagavan, then in that case, there is no problem. Because all duty you are going to, you know, finish. Dhavan Nimilito Netravahi, already discussed Bhagavatam. You know. All due to finish, because you are going to give water at the root of a tree. Bhavanadrumaha, Bhavanadrumaha, Krishna is Bhavana. Urdhamulam adho shakham. Urdhamulam adho shakham. This material world, the root is there of Krishna. Urdhamulam adho shakham. And here you can find all material worlds. It's like, you know, leaves and branches here, but the root is there up. Sangsaradrumaha. This is called Sangsar Briksho. It is called Sangsar Briksho. Sangsaradrumaha. Sangsar Drum mane Briksho. Sangsaradrumaha mane ji Sangsar Briksho. Its mool, the root cause is there up. So if you are going to give water in the root, then you need not give water separately. You need not apply water separately in the branches and tree and leaves. So foolish. You need not do. That's why everything, all duty, you can finish everything done. If you can do Mukunda Seva, Bhagavat Seva, then everything. That is why Bhagavan told that I can take all your responsibility. That is why, in this condition, Bhagavan speaking, you have to leave everything. Sarva dharmana parityajya mamekam saranam bhaja. Only show submission unto my lotus feet. Aham tvam sarva papebhyo mokshayi swami. If you are not going to do your duty, surely you are going to get make some sinful act because you will have to do your duty. But no. If you are 100% inclined to me, then I can save you from danger. No, you need not play your head. It's final Siddhanta actually. So, you need not think about what duty is there, this, that, you need not, but, you know, it is not a matter of joke. You will have to think before taking any step. Before taking any step, you will have to think, you will have to see what is the condition of your mind, how you are doing bhajan. Because basic thing is not clear, then all problem. Somebody can say, Maharaj, Gita is the basic thing, I know. But when Gita going to finish, I know. When Bhagavan Sri Krishna is going to give final advice, this is called final advice. Sarva dharmanam patyaja mamekam saranam bhajo is the final advice. So you can say, this is basic thing. But be sure, where Gita going to finish? Sarva dharmanam parityajam parityajam mamekam saranam. Sarva dharmanam parityajam mamekam saranam bhavyo. That is the last advice of Gita. Without this advice, without applying this advice in your own life, you cannot get entry into Bhagavad Dharma. I know that where Gita going to finish, then our Bhagavad Dharma, I mean there's a Vaishnav Dharma starting. 100% submission, and it is Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking. Without submission, you cannot do Atma Dharma is impossible to flow. Impossible to follow. Yes. Impossible. So when Anasaktobas, when gradually you can develop, gradually if you go on following your own duty, Varnavangasram, gradually you can feel detachment. And Jato Sradhyo Mat Kathasu Nirvinaho Sarvakarmasu. Jato Sradhyo Mat Kathasu. Just now I told, Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking, don't try to disturb them right now. They are ignorant. But Bhagavad Katha, Bhagavad Dharma, so powerful, the Leela Vilas, all the glories of Guru Vaishnava are so powerful, even one hunter was changed. What I mean to say, If I am that kind of powerful, then I can change you. But if I am not powerful, then only disturbance can. If Guru is so powerful, Naraji was so powerful, that even a bad hunter was doing, you know, ferocious activities. But still, by the magic spell of Naraji Maharaj was so powerful, giving mercy, you know, kippa to that bad the hunter, so you are successful. This way, without the kippa of pure Guru Vaishnava, you cannot come out successful. So you will have to follow the usual procedure. Otherwise, if there is any powerful man, powerful Guru Vaishnava, then you can, maybe you can, like the Lakshahira, across, by the power of Haridas Thakur, you must change. So you need power. Not that only you can pass lecture and divert people. So according to their previous karma fall, they must follow their procedure, varnasam dharma, and gradually they can develop. Not that you can break in the middle. It's very, very dangerous. Also, according to the right, we can say according to the right, Gopakumar going off, according to the right, Gopakumar going off, he is originally from, you know, from Vrindavan, Brajadham, and gradually he is going up and up. After that, somebody asking Maharaj, Gopakumar not going to change his body, how is possible for him to go to Golok Vrindavan? You already told that. So I like to give you another reminder. What is that? You can think about Dhruva Maharaj. You can hear this Harikatha, I already told. Dhruva Maharaj, when the plane, chariot came to take Dhruva Maharaj, it is written there, Dhruva Maharaj going to climb that, you know, that chariot without throwing his body. Without throwing his body. But it is written, his body automatically become chinmay. Oh! You know, like fire. Teju, vibhada tejomayam bapum. Similar case there. Gopakumar was engaged by rare procedure, a rare case. So Gopakumar also, why you are going to express doubt by the mercy of Krishna, what not possible? Everything is possible by the mercy of Krishna, by the mercy of Supreme Lord, what not possible? So usually, if somebody is from low caste, you know, patita, fallen soul, any condition, but the Bhagavad Dharma has some extraordinary power. If somebody is from Acharya, so powerful, that is different. Otherwise, you'll have to follow gradual promotional procedure. Don't try to jump. Some excellency can be seen. Like Shukdev Goswami, I will show. Shukdev Goswami was, Shukdev Goswami is speaking, Shukdev Goswami speaking, that I was busy with Nirvishesh Brahma. Shukdev Goswami already speaking, that Parinishchita Opi Nirgunne, Parinishchita Opi Nirgunne, I was busy with Nirgunne, Nirgun Brahma. But you can remember, I already gave indication yesterday. By the magic spell of Vyasadeva Goswami, Shaktabhis Avatar, his, you know, it was a desire. And by the desire of Krishna also. And Sukhdev Goswami also, not ordinary man. Nanda Nandan, Krishna, you know, coming in the form of Sukhdev, it is written document there. Nandanandan Krishna Stushukaha. Nandanandan Krishna coming in the form of Sukadev to advise us. You know. So we are getting advice from Sukadev. You know, what is that? Vishnu Sravana Parikshit Abhavat Vyasaki Kirtani. We are going to hear from Sukadev Goswami. So you see, Sukadev Goswami was busy there in the forest. He was, you know, totally in absorbing condition. But I already told the sloka, Atma Ramaschama, Mahaprabhu told, quotation from Bhagavatam, Mahaprabhu told, Atma Ramaschama nayo nirgantya upi urukrame kuruvanti ahetukim bhaktim ittam bhuto gunahari. Even those who are busy with Nirvishesh Brahma, still they can feel attraction. They can also leave their attraction for Nirvishesh Brahma, they can feel attraction for Supreme Lord. Such a powerful quality of Krishna, you know, that is, his name is Krishna. Powerful, so powerful, Krishna. His Leela, his Vilas, everything. That is why Vyasadeva Goswami, when sending one of his disciples to recite the sloka, Barha piram natabaravapu karnayo karnikaram vibhadabhajaganakakopisam bayantin chamalam randhana vena radara sudaya purayana gopa brindai vrindarannam sapadaramanam pravishad gita kirti. This is a Leela and the beauty of Krishna. Krishna is now in sporting mood, playing, coming. Barha piram natavaravapu karnaya korikaram is so deep meaning actually. I am speaking just overall meaning. Krishna coming from posturing field, Gaucharan, and there Krishna and all boys, they are singing the glories of Krishna. Krishna keeping in the right ear corner one flower, special flower. Barha piram natavarabhapu karnayo kornikaram, kornika flower. To show his heroism, Krishna is hero. Sometimes changing the flower right hand side, left hand side, to prove I am a hero, really hero, the only hero. So Krishna going to, and sometime, you know, so like, you know, one lotus flower is there in hand, like one, you know, chubby ring, you know, key ring, you know, one hero, you know, moving in finger, the ring, a key ring, you know, this way, a lotus flower is moving. To prove his excellency, you know, attraction. So these ways we find, already we know, that Sukhdev Goswami, though he was busy with Nirvishesh Brahma, impersonal Brahma, but still, he was bound to change his mood and come here. And he was the topmost, you know, speaker of Bhagavatam by the mercy of, you know, Krishna. It was possible. So, the basic thing you should understand, that jato saddho mat kathasu, Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking, at all those who are feeling attraction from a katha, without feeling any attraction from harikatha, harikirtan, first of all, the procedure of bhajan is that, shiksha guru, diksha guru, vatma bodhashak guru, you can get everything. So, by the help of Guru Vaishnava, you can cut all asasanga, everything. Gyani, Annavilasi, everything. You can cut all asasanga. Rupa Goswami, and actually Prabhupada speaking, see, Sarup Goswami is the, Sarup Goswami is the main personality, in the main pillar of Gauriya Bhajan. Gauriya Bhajan means main. Pillar means Gauranga, he was giving total responsibility of Gauriya Samaj, Gauriya society, into the hand of Sarva Gosai, in this way. Otherwise, Gauriya Bhajan's main pillar actually Madhavendra Puripad. But here, we see Mahaprabhu giving him responsibility to take control over the this devotional field, Gauriya Vaishnav Samaj. So he is the main leader, you know, of Prakita Vaidantik, Gauriya Vaidantik Acharya. So, Sarup Gosai, Prabhupada speaking, Sarup Gosai never allowed any Mayavadi, you know, to reach Mahaprabhu. Never allowed. If somehow, if you are successful to avoid all Mayavadi, half Mayavadi, full Mayavadi, 20% Mayavadi, you know, is there, 5% still, Mayavad contamination. According to the advice of Sarup Gosai, if we can avoid all Mayavad, Vichar, everything, contamination from our life, devotional life, then we can become free. Kri mean nishanga. Nishanga mean asasanga. Avoid, we can avoid all asasanga. We can get satsanga through Harinam, Harikirtan, everything. So Gaur Hari can give kipa. According to the advice of Sarup Gosai, if we can avoid, if we can drive away all Mayavadi. Prabhupada speaking, by the advice of Sarup Gosai, if we can avoid, Prabhupada speaking, that gradually those Mayavadis, they started, you know, coming into the field of Gauriya Bhajan. Prabhupada speaking, I am not speaking, tomorrow I can discuss. Gradually, when those Mayavadis, they are coming and taking shelter in, you know, false shelter in devotional field of Gauriya Bhajan, from then actually all problems started. All problems started. If we can drive away them, if we can drive them away, that's good. Prabhupada speaking, though even Sarup Gosai is so tough, Sarup Gosai is so, you know, straight cut, Sarup Gosai still Sarup Gosai was busy to request Mahaprabhu on behalf of Choto Haridas. Choto means small Haridas. Prabhupada speaking, even Sarup Gosai is a big personality, is the topmost boss, Gauriya Vaidantik Acharya, who wrote so many things about Gauranga Mahaprabhu. No. He was also busy to request Mahaprabhu on behalf of Choto Haridas. Choto Haridas, what problem he has done, please excuse him. Then Mahaprabhu was very angry, but still, Prabhupada speaking, the Sarup Gosai, he was also, you know, requesting Mahaprabhu on behalf of Choto Haridas. But Sarup Gosai never allowed that Mayavad, Bangiyo Kavi, the material Kavi, his heart was contaminated with Mayavad. His heart was contaminated with Mayavad. So Prabhupada giving us reminder, you can remember, a gigantic personality like Sarup Gosai, who is the topmost, you know, personality in this, you know, Gauriya field, still he was requesting Mahaprabhu on behalf of Sarup Gosai anyway, on behalf of, you know, Choto Haridas. Anyway, Prabhu, excuse, some problem? No, don't speak. Prabhu speaking, Bairagi kare sri sambhasan, dekhite namad napari ami tahar badan. Mahaprabhu speaking, those were entering into, entering this field of, you know, detachment, you know, they are sannyasi brahmachari, they are going to show their detachment, they are already entering into this field of detachment. Still, if they are going to, feel attraction, then I cannot excuse them. I cannot excuse them why they have taken self. If some sannyasi, some brahmachari is going to fall down, then he can go back to his home. He can also marry. He can lead his family life, no problem. But he cannot take any degree of Varna or Ashram. He is out of Varna or Ashram. If at all he is within this area of Vedic field, Bhaktivinoda Thakur Swami, he is out. Now he already took on sannyas. After that, he is Achyuta Gotra, he now fall down. Then after that, he cannot take his previous title and Gotra. No, cannot. He is now out of Varna and Ashram. He can live. And if by his appealing mood, if someday Bhagavan becomes satisfied, he can also get promotion in devotional line. Not that forcefully. Forcefully cannot do. So this way actually, In devotional field, Bhaktivinoda Prabhupada speaking, gradually those Mayavadi, they started taking shelter, false shelter in devotional field, Gauriya Vaishnava field. But their activities, their Siddhanta, their Vichar, everything 100% can prove they are Mayavadi. From then, problems started. Bhaktivinoda Prabhupada speaking. Sarup Gosai, that Prabhupada speaking, even Sarup Gosai was, you know, praying unto lotus feet of Gauranga Mahaprabhu on behalf of Chotoridas. But still, Sarup Gosai never allowed any Mayavadi, I mean Prakita material Kabi, who was writing something about Mahaprabhu and Jagannath, you can remember? If you at all gone through Chaitanya Charitamrita, Sarup Gosai don't allow him. No, no, no. Sarup Gosai is so angry. Are are murkho tui korili sarvanas. You have done great offense unto the lotus feet of both Gauranga and Jagannath. They all same. You know, you are going to differentiate, you know. Dual conception, where from coming? Who is Jagannath? He is Gauranga. Same, you are making some separate conception. Oh, Mayavadi you are. Sarup Gosai was so angry, firing mood. Oh. Then giving advice ultimately. Jao, go and take the association of pure Guru Vaishnava and Gauriya field. Then you can understand what is Siddhanta. Without Gauriya association, Gauriya mat association, somebody knowing Siddhanta is absurd. Absurd. You can come, I can prove. No, nothing. They memorize something, Siddhanta. No, nothing. Without taking shelter unto the lotus feet of Gauriya mat, Chaitanya mat, nobody can never come out successful in Gauriya bhajan. Popa told that. Do you think there is all other procedure? In Delhi, one young man putting, I already told many times before. Do you think there is any other procedure to get the service of Krishna proper way? Eternal service? There is other way, alternative. Do you think so? Prabhupada speaking, no. There is no way. So the only way. So Sarup Gosai never wanted to give entry to that Mayavadi in front of Guru. He checked him. Go. Jao karo, jao karo Vaishnava and karo Vaishnava sangho, Gauriya Vaishnava sangho. Then you can understand what is Siddhanta, this, that. Then you can understand. Sarup Gosai is so firing mood. You know, this way, Mahaprabhu never can bear any Siddhanta virod, rasavas, anything. Cannot bear. Rasavas, Siddhanta virod, sunite, prabhu rahe. That is why Mahaprabhu finally going to depend, finally going to, you know, do this leela. To prove what kind of association you need to get entry into Rupanuga Bhajan. To prove it. Mahaprabhu ultimately going to South India in course of his, South Indian tourage, South Indian pilgrimage, Mahaprabhu running. He was by the advice of, Sarvam Vatajajo, he was bound to meet with Raya Ramananda, because there is, you cannot point out even one who can be compared with Raya Ramananda. Mahaprabhu speaking this way. Only and only Raya Ramananda having that kind of power. Mahaprabhu already told. Ek Raya Ramananda hai vaisho adhikar. Ek Raya, only and only Raya Ramananda. And those who are actually following Raya Ramananda, Sarup Gosai. It is the inner meaning. Mahaprabhu speaking shoutly. Ek Raya Ramananda hai vaisho adhikar. Tate jani aprakita sarita. How you can know? How you can know one Vaishnava, his body is aprakita? How you can know? If you apply this formula, then you can find no attraction. He has no attraction in his life. You know? They are feeling tremendous attraction for Harikatha, Kirtan, everything. But still doctor is going to stop them. This is one kind of Leela. When they are speaking Harikatha, they are never sick. But this is one kind of Leela. Doctor speaking to Baba, don't speak now. Is one kind of Leela. Otherwise, they are never sick. They are always feeling enjoyment, Harikatha, Kirtan, always dancing. But still, this one kind of Leela. So this way, actually, Sarup Gosai never allowed in his whole life, Sarup Gosai never allowed any Mayavadi to come in contact with Mahaprabhu. So Rasabha, Siddhanta Bira, Suniti, Pavurai, Krodh, Prabhu become angry. So it was the major responsibility of Sarup Gosai to check everything. Why I speak major responsibility? Because all of us, Gauriya devotees, if we are at all pure, we have also our duty to check it. In the Sankirtan Jagya, if it is pure Sankirtan, Mahaprabhu is there. So, we cannot find Sarup Gosai in front of us at present. So, we will have to check. So, Sarup Gosai was, major responsibility was given to Sarup Gosai to check. So, anyway, we cannot allow Mayavadi to enter into the field of, you know, Gauriya Bhajan, or at all they come, they will have to change their heart. Otherwise not. So, jato shuddho mat kathasu nirvinno sarva karmasu. Try to understand this formula. How it is possible? Is condition given that jato shuddho, they are developing tremendous attraction for Harikatha Kirtan. Jato shuddho mat kathasu. They are feeling tremendous attraction for Harikatha. Jato shuddho mat kathasu nirvinno sarva karmasu. Nirvinno means totally fed up. Totally fed up with material enjoyment, material, you know, dealings, everything there. Totally. But dry detachment is not good. That's why very often Prabhupada used to speak, non-nirvinno natishakto bhakti yoga asya. Who can come out successful in this devotional field shown by Mahaprabhu? Who is non-nirvinno, who is not having a hate, you know, for material enjoyment. Because at all is not going to show total hate. He is not going to express his hate for material enjoyment. Non-nirvinno, nati-shakto. Nati-shakto, there is no attachment. There is no attachment. No attachment. There is no attachment. At the same time, no enjoying mood. No enjoyment, no attachment. No enjoying mood and no hatred. Both is dangerous. Both. When karmarpan I can discuss, karmarpan, everything I can discuss. And there you can see karmarpan. When first of all varnasam dharma, after that, you know, karmarpan, everything Mahaprabhu, you know, Raya Ramananda speaking, I can discuss in detail. But in karmarpan there is also one kind of very fine false ego there. That I have done, I am going to give the result to Supreme Lord. That is also contamination. That is also contamination. When Bali Maharaj was speaking in front of Bamandev Maharaj, in Jagya Khetra, in the Jagya field, you are coming, Batuk Brahman, you can take anything in donation from me. I can give anything. Anything you like. This was one kind of false ego. But he don't know. He is Supreme Lord. Vishnu. Bali Maharaj could not realize he is speaking. Anything you want I can give you in donation. So is Vishnu. If at all Bali Maharaj that time, Bali Maharaj giving something to Bamandev, that was contaminated. But by the mercy of Prahlad Maharaj, he gradually by the, it was the mercy of Supreme Lord also, gradually he could realize it was only my false ego. Nothing in this infinity world, nothing in this infinity world which I can demand, it is mine. It is my property, my thing, my husband, my son, my daughter, my property, my money. No, I cannot stay. So whereas if you can, you are not going to feel this point. First of all, karmarpan, you should feel this point first. Otherwise your karmarpan is contaminated. You are going to offer, but contaminated. First off, you should feel nothing in this material world, nothing such, you know, you can think is available in the material world, which you can see is mine. It is my thing, my property, my thing, my son, my, no, nothing yours. So this conception should come inside your heart to purify yourself. Otherwise, a very small, you know, smell, slight smell of, you know, doership must be there, or will be there. There is also contamination. So karmarpan also Mahaprabhu speaking, no, I can go back from the beginning, right among the introduction, then we can enter. So now Bali Maharaj, when could realize, oh my God, by that time already Prahlad Maharaj coming to give advice. By that time Bali Maharaj could realize, oh, he is Vishnu himself. And his Gurudev, actually his spiritual guru is actually Prahlad Maharaj. He taught everything for Prahlad Maharaj. And but still, Asura Guru is Sukracharya, that is a general guru. You know. Motirna Kishne Paroto Satova. This slok applicable, Prahlad Maharaj. Motirna Kishne Paroto Satova. Mito vipadde to giho botanam. Adanta govir vishatam tamisram. Punaha puno. Charvito charvanana. Hey, Prahlad, who gives you this idea? How you know this knowledge? Bale Maharaj, how they can know? Motirna kishne parato satubha. Directly, indirectly, no way you can develop this kind of pure knowledge of devotion. Motirna kishne parato satubha. Satumane directly and indirectly, not no way. Mitho vipatte the grihapratanam. Those who are busy with this formula of leading their life like material people. Grihapratanam. I already discussed, you can remember. Grihapratto, grihapratto, I already examined. You know? Already I discussed. Grihapratto, who is grihapratto? You know? And who is, you know, that, no, Griho Medha, Sankirtan Medha, those who are taking resolution that we, those who are taking resolution to give their life for this, you know, sacrifice, Sankirtan sacrifice, Jagya, they are actually Sankirtan Medha, they are developing. And those who are developing Griho Medha, they are developing business mind, how much profit and loss, this mind, this, that material conception can be there. So by that time, Motirna Krishna Parato Satova, Prahlad Maharaj giving this idea that your idea is how people can get bhakti? Impossible. Motirna Krishna Sato Parato Sato. Mitovipaddedu Grihapratanam. Those who are busy with Grihapratanam, for them it is rare thing. Impossible. Grihapratanam. Adanto, they have no controlling over their sense organ and mind. Adanto govir vishatam permission. They are gradually going to enter into tama. Darkness of Tama. Adanto Govir Vishatam Tamishram. Deep and deep, deep and deep into the area of Tama. Adanto Govir Vishatam Tamishram. Punaha Punaha Sarvidachara. Same enjoyment they are getting. Same woman association, same everything. But still they are not going to feel detachment. That is their fault. So anyway, without the help of Guru Vaishnava, nobody can come out. So when Bali Maharaj feeling, I am a donor, oh, I can give anything, any continent or any land, you know, anything, whatever you want. After that, Bali Maharaj discovered, oh my God, I am foolish number one. In this world, in the three worlds, nothing such object which I can see, which I can show, that is my object. That was the condition. Bali Maharaj, that is why Bali Maharaj is Mahajan. Previously, when Bali Maharaj used to say, that time he was not Mahajan. Bali Maharaj, Mahajan, because he was following Prahlad Maharaj Toto last time, for totally. So, he was Mahajan. So, when Bali Maharaj could discover his position, that nothing there, actually, Bamandev Maharaj already covered up everything, all this space, water, land, all gone. Now, what I can give, nothing left. That's why Bhakti Vallabha Tirtha Goswami Maharaj is speaking so nice thing. One day Bhakti Vallabha Tirtha Goswami was speaking. One day I was hearing Harikatha from Srila Sridhar Goswami Maharaj. He came in our mouth. After hearing Harikatha, I was Brahmachari, small Brahmachari, young. I was striking my mind. What Maharaj speaking? Enjoyment is also you'll have to throw. And detachment also you'll have to throw. What? Bhog among tag. Both you will have to throw. Maharaj feeling, I was thinking, bhog enjoyment is prohibited. But tag is prohibited. I don't understand. I must ask this question to, in the leisure time. I can ask. Bhakti Vallabha Tirtha Goswami speaking. When he heard, tag, you will have to throw bhoga mood. You'll have to throw your bhoga mood. And also detachment mode, both. Eh? What is this? I don't understand. Then Maharaj approaching Sridhar Goswami Maharaj, alone. Maharaj, today I hear Harikatha. So long I had this kind of conception that if bhoga should be, we should avoid bhoga. But you see, we should avoid also detachment mode. Well, yes. Then Maharaj Sridhar Goswami Maharaj explaining. Actually, Prabhu, is there anything in this infinity world? What we can deserve is mind. Maharaj then strike, really so? Even your body is not your body. Even your material mind is not your mind. When your mind going to enter into Vrindavan, totally, there is no space. There is no space, no material ground, nothing. That is why Radhanai told, more one Vrindavan, mone mone ek kori mani. When your mind is just equal to Vrindavan, nothing left, then you are successful in Raganuga Bhajan. Be careful. From different angle, I am by the mercy of Guru Vaishnava, I am trying to discuss. So Sridhar Goswami Maharaj then explaining, we should avoid this kind of mood of detachment and attachment, both. Because Yukta Vairagya is so nice balance. Because what you have that you can even mind. So I am giving this flower to Krishna. Your flower, you buy it from market. Foolish. Flower is already there in the trees and already grown by Supreme Lord. So we demand this doership was there, going to put us in trouble. So we should get rid of this detachment mood and attachment mood, both. That is why I told, Bhav Prabhupada very often used to say, that is called Yukta Vairagya. To explain this Yukta Vairagya, Prabhupada used to speak, Nanirvinno Nati Shakta Bhakti Yoga Asya Siddhito. Who is following tremendous detachment, he cannot do bhajan. Yukta Vairagya cannot do. He is feeling tremendous attraction? No, he also cannot. Follow this Gauriya Vajan is impossible. Without Yukta Vairagya, balanced Vairagya, all proper adjustment for Krishna Seva, this principle you will have to apply. Everywhere, each and everywhere, every field you will have to apply and come out successful. Not that philosophically you can apply. Practically, you have to apply in your own life and you have to see you are successful or failure. If one time failure, then second time try, third time, fourth time, you go on trying. Maybe by the mercy of Guru Vaishnava, if you are going to enjoy the full kripa of a pure Vaishnava, if pure Guru Vaishnava is going to love you from heart, be sure you are going to get green signal in your life. Bhaktivallabha Tirtha Goswami speaking this way, that day I was very shocked. It was very interesting. When I heard, really so, Yukta Vairagya is so balanced, you know, so nice demarcation that we make confusion. We make confusion, we don't understand. So Karmarpan I can discuss tomorrow. And Prahlad, and by the mercy of Prahlad Maharaj, when Bali Maharaj could realize, really so, all taken by Vishnu, and we have nothing to say, because Vishnu is the all-pervading Lord, Supreme Lord. He is the owner of everything. He is the owner of everything in infinity world. Vishnu, Vishnu, Vishnu. Jashaika nishishito kalo mathavalambo jivanti loma vilaja jagadandanatha vishwar mahanasa iho yasso kalavishesho govindam adi purusham tamaham bhajami. This Vishnu, you know, Karuna Navasai Vishnu, infinity world. There in his all tips of here, body here. Enough. Is that this is the conception you should. So, Bali Maharaj now discover I am in a very painful situation. So long I was popped up. I am the owner of, you know, Sargamatta, Patal, everything. Ah, but now I say I am poor. I have nothing. You know, that is the basic teaching of Gita. That is the basic teaching of what you have. So that you can cry if going to loss. What you had in future, in past, for that you can cry. What you can get in future, as, you know, in future, so that you can say it is mine, nothing yours. Nothing yours, you cannot demand. Even when your body getting maturity inside the womb of your mother, it is also one kind of ingredients taken from this prakriti, nature. When fertilization took place, it is called nishek in Sanskrit and Bengali. Fertilization was there, ovary and sperm. Then zygote formation, medical term, inside the womb of mother. You know, everything, right from whatever you think, Anyat Bhavati Pajya, I already told. Yes. Why I told? Now you can remember. Now you can remember, oh my God, why Maharaj told everything? That's why to break your wrong conception. Anyat Bhavanti Bhutani Pajanyat Anna Sambhavaha. Jagyat Bhavati Pajanno Jagyaha Karma Samud Bhavaha. Karma Brahmat Bhavam Vidhi Brahmakshara Samud Bhavam. Tasmat Sarvagatam Brahma Nityam Yogya Pratishthitam. So from Anya, you are getting power, they are going to give birth to children, everything, all right from the beginning. All the ingredients of mat is nature. Nothing you, only the Chinma Yivatma is there, waiting to take birth. After taking birth, the Jivatma, oh, it's my body, I'm so nice, so beautiful girl. Eh? Foolish. Is your body? Eh? Then why not going to obey your, you know, instruction? No, nothing. Even your material mind, not under your control, it is also matter. Your body matter, all, whatever, all your possession, whatever you have, all material. All you have taken from this nature, prakriti, and when you are going to leave your body, you will have to leave everything. Your body. Only the spirit can go away from your body and your karma fall can follow you. So now you understand. Now you try to follow. What is the basic teaching of Gita? You have no idea. Even your body you cannot claim, that is my body. Body also, whenever you show submission unto the lotus feet of Guru Vaishnava, then the body is for the service of Guru Vaishnava. You cannot say it is my body. You have no right to speak that way. So this way actually, when you are going to leave body, all, you know, all material composition of chemistry in your body, all copper, carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, whatever you have, composition, you know, in different form. You know, this body formation was there by the help of this nature. Now when you are going to leave this body, then you are going to give away. Water you are going to give away, light, everything, whatever you have, all you are going to give away, return back. If you take birth, again you have to suffer. So this is the basic thing, you see. So you have nothing. First of all, you try to understand this thing. Otherwise, no use. It is only dry philosophy. If I can discuss all Radha-Manasa, I finish. You can become gopi overnight, and I can also become idiot, to speak that way. So I am taking trouble to explain by the mercy of Prabhupada Guru Bhargava, so that I can give a clear impression. If I cannot take you, if I am failure to take you out of your bodily conception, then Radha-Manan Sangbad I cannot, you know, explain properly. You cannot understand. First of all, I have to take you out of this bodily conception. Sukhdev Goswami, when speaking Bhagavad Katha to Parikshit Maharaj, then Sukhdev Goswami was very clever. He was very clever. You saw, before discussing pure devotional practice, I mean 10th canto, full of lila, Parikshit Maharaj, you know, was there. Sukhdev Goswami said again, well, you have to take rest actually for a long time, you are hearing non-stop, you are feeling thirsty and you are hungry, you have to take rest and off, sleep. No, Gurudev, no. Pivantam tanma khambajachyutam harikathamritam. Don't stop. It is my request unto you all, Gurudev, don't stop. I am drinking. What you are drinking? No water, nothing, juice, nothing. Bala Maharaj, I am drinking. Pivantam tan mukhamja harikathamritam. I am, you know, and I am drinking the nectar and harikatha. I am beyond this conception of, you know, bodily demand. I am not feeling thirst and hungry. No, I am not feeling, you know, it necessary to take rest. Nothing. I am beyond. I mean, before giving secret thing, Sukhdev Goswami wanted to test his disciple. His name is Parikshit. Parikshit Mani already tested and found okay and given one, you know, one symbol, trademark, is okay. Whenever factory manufacturing some good and then testing, and after tested and found okay. You know, tested and found okay. This way actually, Parikshit Maharaj was tested and found okay by Sukhdev Goswami. That's why he could get entry into this, you know, very secret Lila Vilas, I mean, to get entry into pure devotional practice. So now, I like to clarify this point. When Bali Maharaj could realize, oh my God, I am foolish number one. Nothing in this world. What I can pay? What I can donate to Vishnu, Bhagavan? Nothing I have. Even my body is not. You know, then by the mercy of Bhagavan and Prahlad Maharaj, you know, he finally, Bindavali, his wife, going to advise, why not you offer your head? At least you have Jivatma, Atma is there, at least because it is my body. But the body is not, but still, you can speak, Prabhu, I have nothing to pay you, ultimately I am going to offer my head so that you can keep your third leg on my head. That's a devotional mode. Finally, the third leg of Bhamandev Maharaj, Bali Maharaj is going to take, and now he is Acharya, devotional Acharya. You know, sarvasma sarvatma nivedane balir abhut. Bali was successful in nivedan, atma nivedan. Nine folds of bhakti, na? So why you speak Bali Maharaj is successful? Bali Maharaj is Mahajan. Bali Maharaj Mahajan, because he is successful. Now he is, and I understand nothing there in this, you know, infinity world. So this realization was there with Bali Maharaj by then. But we cannot realize. So karmarpan is also dangerous. So now for the long time I was discussing about, you know, varnasam dharma, which is external, we know. We know it is external, because finally it is no use. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, finally it is no use. We will have to avoid. A Vaishnava, pure Vaishnava, you cannot confine a pure Vaishnava within this category of guna karma. Not possible. But ultimately you are going to throw it, but not now. That adhikar, that right you should attain, after that you can throw, not now. You can go on thinking, it is external, you can throw everything. No, you cannot speak right now. You have to follow exact procedure through which, if you run, then you can come out successful. Otherwise, not. So you understand that is why Bali Maharaj was our Mahaj. Bali Maharaj is our Mahajan. So, he was successful. So, jato saddho mat kathasu, when a jivatma going to attain tremendous attraction, going to feel, mat kathasu, mane bhagavat katha, bhagavanir katha, nirvinno, sarva karmasu, he is going to lose this attraction for material activities. He is going to lose his attraction for material activities. You know, nirvinno, sarva karmasu, he is not feeling it necessary to do all this and that, nothing. So, yato saddho mat kathasu, nirvinnaha sarva karmasu, or he is going to avoid. And, vedo dukshatto kano kamano parityage upi anishwaraha. Follow. He can realize this really, the material mark, karma mark. I already told yesterday, what is painful, this karma mark. Vedo, he can realize that what is painful, this karma mark. This is the way of karma. His network is so dangerous. I know one Sedji, you know, I speak, Sedji, you can start your bhajan. Yes, Maharaj. Yes, Maharaj. Haan, Maharaj. Oh, hamara ek ladki hai, uska sadhi ho jaye. First of all, I give arrange marriage for my and daughter one, then I can start bhajan. After that marriage was over, Sedji, now you can start your bhajan. Oh, well, actually, my daughter going to give birth one baby, I should see. And after that a baby growing up, that a grandfather going at attachment, so love, kissing, love, so much. Now after that, this way, he get involved in material activities. Karma mark is never safe. Karma mark is never safe, it is dangerous. Don't try to follow karma mark. It's very dangerous. So only way open is to do pure devotion. If you can do pure devotion, it's good. So, jato sraddho mat kathasu nirvinna sarva karmasu, if you feel fed up, like the tirandi sannyasi, vedo dukkhyatmakano kamano, this material activity is really painful, source of pain, all pain, I cannot avoid. And they like to put it, when feeling this way, parityage opi anishwara, but still he feel, but not going to leave at once, not at present, cannot leave. In that case, tato payetomang pritaha, at least he should have strong belief that Krishna bhajan, Hari bhajan can give me everything. Everything. So, about pure devotion in the Bhagavatam, already you know it is written, you know, already is written in Bhagavatam already that without any desire, ahituki bhakti, there is no reason. There is reason for why you are showing bhakti. You know, you are developing that kind of mood when you can show that there is ahituki bhakti. You know, you can develop ahituki bhakti. That is the procedure. Bhakti. Ahituki bhakti, you will have to attain this stage. Otherwise, big problem. You cannot get rid. So, no, nirvinno, you have to understand this, you know, procedure of yukta vairagya, which is next to impossible to understand. Only by the mercy of Gopiyar Guru Vaishnava you can realize. And when you can realize this, you know, yukta vairagya, then Haribhajan, what is Haribhajan? To understand what is Haribhajan. I heard from my Guru Varga, to understand what is Haribhajan. It is taking long, birth after birth, we are going to lose time to understand what is Haribhajan. What is Haribhajan? To understand this thing, we are going to lose our time. But now, we are not going to waste our time. Now, we will have to understand everything. What was the mood of Rai Ramananda? What was the mood of Gauranga Mahaprabhu? What Gauranga Mahaprabhu wanted to speak? Why Mahaprabhu doing this kind of leela? Why Mahaprabhu going to manifest this kind of leela? Mahaprabhu could easily speak Bhagavat Tattva Vigyan himself, like in Gita. And Maharaj, you are giving advice to Supreme Lord. You think Supreme Lord is foolish? Eh? You think Supreme Lord foolish? In Gita, when Bhagavan giving advice, mat judging mang namaskuru, you know, and after that, sarva dharmanam pratyaj, but most of the people not going to believe. That thing is very clever. He's going to speak, mat judging, you worship me, you come to me. It's very clever. Most of the people, they're thinking. So if you think Bhagavan is foolish, no. Who is maintaining infinity worlds? There's some reason behind it. If Bhagavan going to speak directly, this is the mood, then it's problem. People can express some doubt. That's why Bhagavan going to ask question in front of Rai Ramananda, and Rai Ramananda going to speak all in Jesus. Only Mahaprabhu going to put question, one by one question, and Mahaprabhu wanted to get answer from the mouth of Rai Ramananda, so that whole world can speak. Oh, it's not spoken. Mahaprabhu only asking question, and Rai Ramananda giving answer. So it's okay. Otherwise, everybody going to express doubt about Bhagavan Supreme Lord all the time. That's why Mahaprabhu was bound to follow this, you know, technique. So, through this procedure, I mean question answer, Mahaprabhu wanted to give details, wanted to speak in detail about Saddha Sadhana Takta, one by one, gradually. Saddha Sadhana Takta. So, first of all, you can remember, Raya Mahasaya, when I can speak all in details from tomorrow, in details. So there you can find at the bank of Godavari, there in Vidyanagar, I can start when Rai Ramananda meet with Mahaprabhu, this, that, from this point, because it has some ground also, has some basic thing. So when he was asked about Sadhasana Tattva, first of all, by the desire of Mahaprabhu, because Rai Ramananda is Rasik Bhakta from beginning. Then now question is that when Mahaprabhu asking this, why not Ramananda, Rai Ramananda could answer that final thing, because he is, you know, Rasik Bhakta, he could, you know, answer. Why is starting from the basic point? But it was the desire of Gauranga. It was the desire of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, that's why he thought it necessary to start from the beginning. Otherwise, he is Rasik Bhakta. He could start in the beginning. Prabhu is, you know, Radha Dasya, or the mood of Radharani is the final, you know. He could easily speak, but not that. Rayamas are speaking because by the desire of Raya Ramananda speaking. Raya Ramananda by the desire of Gauranga, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is speaking, that's why he is starting from the beginning. So, Raya Ramananda started from the beginning, Vishnu Puran, giving the documents from Vishnu Puran, I can speak tomorrow, Varnasrama Bhattacharam, I can speak. So, Raya Mahasaya started giving example and speaking and starting from, you know, Varnasrama Dharma. You know, Varnasrama Dharma first, and in those who are established in Varnasrama Dharma, Karma Mishra Archan Ekata, first of all, he wanted to establish. When Mahaprabhu was not satisfied, then he started speaking about, you know, Krishna Karmarpan. That was also, I already explained so many things, Karmarpan is not so easy. And also it is not pure devotion. It is not, because inside there is some false, small smell of false ego can be there. That's why Mahaprabhu, you have to speak more deep. Yo by yo, it is external. Then Varnasrama Dharma tag, he was speaking. After that Mahaprabhu, it is also external tag. I can discuss all in details tomorrow. So, you will have to wait for that. So, try to understand. Try to understand all in detail. Try to digest. Try to digest all in detail so that you can step into Raya Ramananda properly. Evam mano karma basam prayukte avidyatmoni upadhiyamane pritirna yavadamayivasudeve namochate deho yoge natavat vancha kalpadurvasi kepasindu bhavachavati thanang pavane bhyo vaishnavi bhyo namo namaha.